Hello guys, in this video we are going to discuss about AVL deletion. There are some previous videos I have explained about AVL insertion, AVL rotations, AVL trees, binary search trees, etc. So if you find it useful, please do watch those videos in the description. So let's go directly into our video. Here I have taken a balanced AVL tree as an example, and the balancing factor of each and every node is written. Balancing factor of tree leaf nodes will always be 0, and in this case height of left subtree, that is 1 minus height of right subtree 1, so 1 minus 1 0, and in this case height of left subtree, that is 0, 0 minus 1 minus 1, in this case height of left subtree 1 minus right subtree 0, so 1 minus 0 1, and in this case height of left subtree 1 minus right subtree 1, so 1 minus 1 0. And in this case, height of left subtree, that is 2 minus height of right subtree 2. So 2 minus 2, 0. And in this case, height of left subtree again 2, height of right subtree 2. So 2 minus 2, 0. And in the case of the root node, height of left subtree is 1, 2, 3. And height of right subtree is again 3. So 3 minus 3 is 0. So now we can see that since the balancing factor is 0 or 1 or minus 1, if balancing factor is any of this value, we can say that that particular tree is balanced. So this is our question. In an AVL deletion, various cases are there. Among them, the first one is deletion of a leaf node. So here I have taken a leaf node 14, wherein which the balancing factor is always be 0. In this case, how we can delete this particular node 14? In the case of such a node, that is where in which we have to delete a leaf node, we can actually delete the leaf node directly. We don't need to perform anything, we need to delete the node directly. So now our question or this given AVL tree become like this, where in which 14 is removed from here. After the deletion of a node, we always have to recalculate the balancing factor of each and every node. So here let's recalculate the balancing factor. Balancing factor of leaf nodes are always 0. Here also 0. Balancing factor of left subtree minus right subtree. So 1 minus 1, 0. Here 2, in the case of this node, 2 minus 1, 1. In the case of this node, 3 minus 3, 0, and here 2 minus 2, 0, and here 1 minus 0, 1, and here 1 minus 1, 0. Now we know that our tree do not have any problem, that is balancing factor of each and every node is either 0 or 1 or minus 1. So we know need not to be perform any of the AVL rotation, we can just proceed. Now the second scenario or the second case is that we need to delete a node who have one child. Okay, suppose consider that from this tree I have to delete 18, and I know that this 18 have a single child, either a left child or right child. So if such a scenario occur, that belongs to the case 2 condition, that is deletion of a node who have one child. In such a scenario, what we have to do is that we can delete the specific node directly, and the left or right child of that node has to be placed in place of this deleted node. Okay, so here what we have done, we have deleted this 18 directly, and in place of 18 its child 16 is placed. So this is the final tree. Now let's recalculate the balancing factor. These are leaf nodes, so 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0. And in this case, 1 minus 1, so 0. And in the case of this node, 2 minus 1, so 1. And in case of this node, 3 minus 3, so 0. In this node, 1 minus 2, so minus 1. And in the case of this node, 1 minus 1, so 0. Now we know that the balancing factor is either in between 0, 1 or minus 1. So we need not to be perform any AVL rotation, you can just proceed. Now let's look into another example where in which I have to delete this node 60. Okay, so if such a scenario occur, that actually belongs to case 3, where in which the node that has to be deleted have two child, left child and right child are present. So that is the third scenario. In such a case, if we need to delete this 60, what how to be done? We can replace this node with its in order predecessor or in order successor. Okay, for the easy understanding, let's just write the in order traversal of this specific tree. Okay, we know that in an in order traversal, first of all, we need to traverse through the left child, then the root node, after that right child. So this is how an in order traversal will work. So first traverse to its left child, so goes to its left child. In this specific node also this condition is applicable, so we goes to the left child of this node, that is this. In this node also this condition is applicable, so we just go to the left child of this node. So 5, since 5 do not have any child, we can just write 5. So 5 is visited first, after that the root node is visited, that is 8, after that its right child is visited, that is 9. Now the condition for this child become okay. So this was actually the left child traversal of this node 12. So of this specific node 12, its left child is traversed. So now we can traverse this 12. After that its right child can be visited, that is 13. Now in the case of this node 50, its left child is already visited, right? We can visit this node, that is 15. After that we have to visit its right child, so we came to its right child. In this specific node also this condition is applied, left root and right, so we goes to the left child of this node, that is 16. Since 16 do not have any child, we can visit 16 directly. So regarding with this node, left child visited, so we have to visit the root, that is 54. After that we have to visit its right child. In right child also have so many children, so this rule is also applicable to this node. So goes to the just visit the left of this node, that is 56. After that this node is visited, that is 60. Then its right child is visited, that is 70. So this is the in order traversal of this specific node. Now we have to delete this specific node 60. 60 has to be replaced with either of its in-order predecessor or in-order successor. Now let's go with the in-order predecessor. 60. In-order predecessor means the element that is present just before the specific node, that is 56. So here this 56 is the in-order predecessor of 60. Okay. Since this is a binary search tree, we do not go for this in order traversal, because since it is a binary search tree, we know it's very clearly that the in order predecessor of a particular node will be highest element in its left child. Okay. And the in order successor of a particular node will be the smallest element in its right child. So here from this itself, we can without going for this in order traversal, we can directly write the in order predecessor of 60, that is 56, since 56 is the highest element in the left child of 60. Suppose that we have to find the in order predecessor of 12. What will be the in order predecessor of 12? In order predecessor of 12 will be the highest element in the left child. So the left child of 12 is this, and the highest element present in this left child is 9. Okay, so 9 will be the in order predecessor of 12. For clarification, this is not a traversal. So this is our tall. 9 is the inorder predecessor or inorder predecessor of this tall. So without writing, I just write this inorder traversal for a clear understanding. Without writing this inorder traversal, we can directly write the inorder predecessor and inorder successor of a root from this tree itself. No need to go for this. We can directly find it from the tree itself. So we begin with 60. We need to delete this element 60. 60 has to be replaced with its inorder predecessor or successor. Let's go for inorder predecessor. So 60 has to be replaced with its inorder predecessor. So that is the case 3, wherein which the not to be deleted have two child. So here we actually replace our 60 with the inorder predecessor 56, and the 60 is deleted directly. After that, we have to find the balancing factor of this tree. So balancing factor of root, balancing factor of the leaf is 0. So 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0. This is 1 minus 1, so 0. This is 2 minus 1, so 1. And this is 3 minus 3, so 0. And here 1 minus 2, so minus 1. And here 0 minus 1, so minus 1. Since balancing factor of all of this not is in is either 0, 1 or minus 1, we can say that this tree is balanced. Now the next case is we have to delete the element 54. So this is 54. Here if we need to delete the node 54, which case is it? This is the third case, that is the node to be deleted have two child. In such a case, we can replace this node with its inorder predecessor or inorder successor. Then let's go for inorder predecessor. Inorder predecessor of this 54 is, we know that the highest element that is present in the left child of this node, that is 60. Here 54 is removed and it is replaced with the 16. Now let's find the balancing factor of each and node. So this is leaves, so 0, 0, 0 and 0. And this is 1 minus 1, so 0. And here 2 minus 1, so 1. Here 3 minus 3, so 0. Here 0 minus 2, so minus 2. And here 0 minus 1, so minus 1. We know that in the case of this node, the balancing factor is minus 2. So we can say that this particular tree become imbalanced or unbalanced. We have to perform a suitable rotation to make it balanced. Now the next step is we have to identify which rotation has to be performed. Okay, we have four types of rotation. Among this four type, which rotation has to be performed? Imbalance occur here. So this is RR condition. We know that if a condition like this occur, the rotation that we have to be performed is a left rotation. And left rotation is actually an anti-clockwise rotation. So here this 56 move upward and 16 come downward. So like this 56 move upward and here 16 come downward. 70 is written as such. So this is the case of the tree after a rotation. Now let's see the balancing factor of each of the node. This is leaves, so 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0. This is 1 minus 1, so 0. And here 2 minus 1, so 1. And we know that all the balancing factors are okay. They are either 0, minus 1 or 1. So they are not violating our condition. So we can say that this is a balanced tree. And this is how a deletion of nodes will be performed in AVL tree. So I hope that it's clear.